There is yet another stark report out today detailing how the increased warming of the Earth's atmosphere is transforming the planet. As William Brangham reports, the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration's annual Arctic report card has just been released, and the news for wildlife, native communities, and global sea level rise is not good.
That's right, Judy. This report shows that warming in the Arctic is having dramatic impacts now, with worse yet to come. Sea and land ice is disappearing at unprecedented rates. Permafrost is continuing to thaw, releasing more carbon and methane, which will only make warming worse. Fish and bird species are also suffering, and native communities are seeing their home transformed. Joining me now is Erich Osterberg of Dartmouth University. He's a scientist who has studied ice loss on Greenland. Erich, thank you very much for being here. I wonder if you could just give us a sense of what jumps out most at you from this report.
Yeah, I think the headline from this report is that the Arctic is in real trouble. If this were an annual health checkup, I think we'd have to say that the Arctic is chronically sick and getting worse. 2019 was a particularly bad year for the Arctic. We saw the second warmest temperatures that we'd ever seen on record. And those warm temperatures led to near record levels of melting of the sea ice on the Arctic Ocean and also near record levels of melting of the glaciers on Greenland, which raises sea level. So it's a really sobering report, but I have to say it's not a very surprising report because this is a continuation of the trends that we've been seeing happening in the Arctic for quite a few decades now as climate change has gotten worse.
Your particular expertise is in ice, and as you mentioned, the ice sheet on Greenland, which is, I believe, the second largest structure of ice on Earth, is losing ice at an accelerating rate. Can you give us a sense of the scale of the loss happening there?
Yeah, it's enormous numbers, so it's hard to comprehend. It's about 250 billion tons of ice that gets lost from Greenland every year and goes into the ocean. And for your viewers to conceptualize that, I want them to think about a herd of elephants charging into the ocean off of Greenland. And in order to equal the amount of mass that gets lost from Greenland every year, you need 2,000 elephants charging into the ocean every second. So these are enormous amounts of mass every second. So, you know, this is going right into the ocean and it's raising sea levels around the world, which is affecting communities that live on the coastline.
It really is an incredibly striking and dire image you're painting. The warming, as I mentioned in my introduction, is also causing the permafrost to thaw. Mm. We know permafrost by its name is land that is normally permanently frozen. Why is it such a concern to the scientific community when permafrost goes from being frozen to starting to thaw?
So it's a concern because there's a lot of extra carbon that's stored in the permafrost. And it's when it's frozen, that's okay because it means it's not in the atmosphere. And it's carbon in the atmosphere that causes the warming. The problem is that as that permafrost melts, some of that carbon gets released into the atmosphere as CO2 and methane. And so this is a climate change amplifier. And for a long time, we've been studying, trying to figure out, on average, is there more carbon going up into the atmosphere from the permafrost? And this report is striking because it's really the first time they've come out and said, yes, we believe that the permafrost is now contributing CO2 into the environment. It's now become this climate change amplifier that we feared. And I'd say that this is really sort of tip of the spear science here. I think we need a lot more research to confirm these findings. But this is something we've been worried about as a scientific community for a while now, and now we're starting to see indications that it's happening.
This report also touches on a lot of the downstream impacts of this warming on fish species, on bird species, on the humans that live there. Can you tell us a little bit about how warming is impacting them?
Yeah, so the report does a nice job of talking about different species like the ivory gull, which has seen a 70% decline in its population. And as the oceans get warmer, we know that the fish species are migrating. These fish need cold water, and as the waters warm up with sea ice loss, they have to migrate away, and that affects the whole ecosystem, and it affects the fishing industry there. This is a billion-dollar fishing industry in the Bering Sea off Alaska, and so it affects that industry, and it affects the local native communities who live there on the coastline and depend on those fish for their subsistence.
All right, Erich Osterberg of Dartmouth University, thank you very, very much.
You're welcome. It's good to be with you.